This is Bharathi Dhasan, Assistant Professor from RMD Engineering College. In this session, we are going to see how to measure the characteristics of microwave signal. By generating a microwave signal by using a reflex crystal power supply, and how to measure the characteristics and the power value, VSWR value, frequency, wavelength, and the S parameter, everything we are going to measure for the generated microwave signal from the reflex crystal oscillator. Here, we have a microwave test bench to generate a microwave signal. This is a microwave test bench. In the first element is the reflex crystal mount. In the reflex crystal mount, by giving a proper beam voltage and a Rippler voltage, the signal, microwave signal, can be generated here. The generated signal is first passed through the isolator. The purpose of passing through the isolator is it blocks the unwanted signal in a reverse direction. It allows the signal only in a forward direction. Next to the attenuator, we have a variable attenuator. This variable attenuator is used to pause the signal in a required manner. Then next element is the frequency meter. It can be used to measure the frequency value of the microwave signal generated from the reflex crystal. Next to the frequency meter, we have a starter line section. In the starter line section, we have a vernier scale to find the voltage minimum values of the microwaves, and then we have a detector tunable probe section to get the output. Then the final element is the detector mount. It is connected here to see the output on the CRO. This is a reflex crystal power supply. Before switch on the reflex crystal power supply, initially the beam voltage knob should be in anti-clockwise direction and the Rippler voltage knob should be in a clockwise direction, and the meter selection should be in a current mode, and the modulation should be in amplitude AM. After switch on the reflex crystal power supply, we have to wait for some time for the current value to get constant, because the reflex crystal mount, in the reflex crystal mount, it takes some time to respond for the proper voltage given to the reflex crystal power supply. See, initially the current value is zero, and now it is increasing to up to some value to get a constant value. Now it is 9 and it reaches 10. Now by moving this meter selection to the beam voltage, initially it was 200. We have to adjust that value to the range of 240 to 300 value. Then the meter selection should be moved on the Rippler mode. On Rippler mode, the maximum value is available here is -280 voltage. By reducing the Rippler voltage, we can get a microwave signal generated by the reflex crystal power supply at a particular value of the Rippler voltage. At the particular value of the Rippler voltage, we are getting a microwave signal generated by the source. We can view that signal on the CRO from the by using a detector mount. See, here we can able to see the microwave signal generated by the reflex crystal as a square wave. This is the procedure to generate a microwave signal by using a microwave test bench. For the generated microwave signal, we can measure the parameters. Initially, to measure the S parameter value, we can use the E-plane T, H-plane T, magic T, directional coupler, isolator, and the separator components. By using those components, we can measure the S parameter value. Then, by using the horn antenna, by using two horn antennas, by transmitting one antenna, for receiving one antenna, we can measure the radiation pattern of the microwave signal. By using this horn antenna, the radiation pattern of the microwave signal can be measured. Then the power value and attenuator value, attenuation value can be measured by using the attenuator, and the power value can be directly measured by using a power meter, and also the VSWR value can be measured by using a VSWR meter. To measure the wavelength, here we are having a starter line section, and to measure the frequency, we have a frequency meter. By using these two frequency meter, we can directly measure the frequency of the microwave signal generated from the reflex crystal power supply. Here we are having the components which are working based upon the X band of frequency. Our X band of frequency is 8 to 12 GHz. All the components are designed here to work on the X band of frequency. So the generated frequency by the reflex crystal here will produce a microwave range from 8 to 12 GHz. Thank you.